Elvis poems, and most of them are about Elvis, his biography. I mean, that figures into most of them, but this one actually is my biography. This is a Sestina, so you can hear the repeating line endings. There was a place where, when I was in high school, there's always a place where everybody goes to park and make out. And the place where we went was called Tilly Willy. It was a quarry. It was an old quarry area. And so the name of this poem is Tilly Willy Fog. I'm kissing his poster. My knee, let me start over. I'm kissing his poster on my knees, on my bed. We're both children in a way. Maybe we stop at 15. We could easily be in the fogged up car at Tilly Willy Quarry. We haven't, you know, yet. It begins here. The rest seems like a vast openness. I cannot imagine past his hand up my skirt any more than he could imagine handing back his songs to silence or lying on his deathbed without Priscilla or Kathy or Linda or Joe or vast numbers of other girls called in to stop his mind enough so he could sleep. What we know together is half-shut eyes. Call it a fog of desire if you want. But there is something in the fog that is not us, an alertness of mind, a hand running over the entirety of what we know and calling it good. No matter whose bed you get in later, something in your mind stops here. You and Elvis touch lips across the vast distance. Don't sap this up. The truth is vaster than the jewel-belted icon stumbling in a fog of barbiturates. The vibration of the universe never stops. It's all song, the hum of molecules in the hand and lips. And what goes away comes back, a flower bed of humming, spilling over the edge of what you know. You think the fat women who cried didn't know what they cried for when he died? It's no vast distance between them and me. Our souls are bedded in our hungry bodies, taking advantage of the fog at Tilly Willy. Please let me put my hand there, he says, and being scared, he stops there. Nothing ever felt this good to stop on that note, the mouth wide open, no thought left, no design, waiting for the hand of God to move on or intervene. It's vastness, it's plenty, it's human spring, pure song, a fog of wastefulness. You get out of bed the rest of your life knowing it's Elvis's bed you've come from, vast, vibrating. On the one hand, you're stopped, flesh and bone. On the other, you're a song. So I mostly grew up in Arkansas, and after I left Arkansas, somebody asked me what was it like growing up there, and so this poem was kind of an answer to that. I grew up in Fayetteville, which is in the Ozark Mountains. It's in the northwest corner of Arkansas. It's very beautiful, very mountainous, and so that kind of mountainous quality sort of gets into you. What it was like, my mother dragging the vacuum cleaner like a large cockroach room to room. My mother folded like a moth sitting on the stoop. She's not crying now. She sips her Pepsi through a straw. She's mad, she says, as if it were only a bug in her throat. I grow alert as a deer. I grow aware of bad local grammar, hordes at the gate. I roar off with my friends down Dixon Street, bringing civilization to Arkansas in someone's T-bird. Some conglomerate picture shifting as if underwater, not that, but a womb thickness. I push through, assembling as I go. I wish I could hold onto my mother's feet, very small and white, high arched, ticklish, her feet only, far enough from her eyes in my memory, one brown pupil off to the side, trying to escape. the other dutiful, their hopeless drama. Don't look at them, but at the mottled pattern of the linoleum countertop, the flared aluminum legs of the dinette, my rage exactly equal to my love, two pistons. You ask me what I remember. I'm halfway up Mount Sequoia on the other side, gasping for breath. I turn to catch the long Ozark Valley, the glorious translucent yellow of maples. I'll call it mothering because of the way the land and sky hold you, and at the same time lay a hand on the back of your neck like a dangerous lover.